Well, I'll tell you one thing. I ain't cleaning up this mess.
Well, you gotta look on the bright side, Jane. Actually, so you only have one chore to do now.
I've never seen a fire spread so fast in all my life. This house got well done quicker than a barbecue chicken.
It came up out of nowhere, blowing fire every which way. Look at that.
Look at that. That's the first time I've ever seen a swimming pool burn down.
Now, how come the fire department never answered the alarm? And how come no neighbors bothered coming over to help us? And how come when it rained everywhere else but right here? I ain't a gambling woman, Morris, but I got a feeling this family has cracked out.
You think it's true, Manny?
What's that?
That the Lord is testing Mr. Benjamin, that it's God. That it's God who's burned us and froze us and starved us just to see if Mr. Benjamin loves him like you say he do.
I hope so. Sure would be a waste if all this misery was nothing but misery. What time is it?
What difference does it make around here? It's time for Mr. Benjamin getting up. Hold on. You ready?
Thank you.
What's that, Mr. Benjamin?
Hell and who?
It hurts when speak his lips get stuck together.
Of course.
What are you trying to say, dear?
Hell and who?
A nail in your shoe. Where's David? I don't know, dear. David's gone.
David's gone?
Yes, but he'll be all right. You mustn't worry. You must take care of yourself now, Joe.
David's gone.
Well, it's nice to see you up and around, Mr. Benjamin.
Yeah. Dinner's gonna be ready soon. We're having a potluck.
Stand like that, Mr. Benjamin. Here, let me help you sit.
No, no, no!
Don't touch him!
I won't touch him!
You mustn't touch him.
I promise I won't touch you, Mr. Benjamin.
Don't touch. Mustn't touch.
No one's going to touch you, dear. We know how your skin feels.
Skin feels hot.
Skin feels hot, we know, darling.
Oh, Daddy. Poor Daddy.
He needs a strike. That's what he needs. Would you like a nice carrot, Mr. Benjamin?
Cahoo.
What's that?
Cahoo.
He can't chew.
Would you like a drink?
Swallow.
He can't swallow.
Oh.
Is there anything we can do, Daddy?
Coffee.
I can't think of anything.
Go. Eddie, go.
Everything's gone. No, Joe, not everything. We have each other. We're all alive and together, Joe.
Eddie, go. In here.
Don't touch it, Joe. Just point to it.
Poor Daddy.
Away. Take away.
They're your children, Joe. They love you.
We're not leaving you, Daddy.
We're sticking, Dad, even if the pain gets worse.
Worse. Worse than this. No. No worse. This is it.
That's right. Things are going to get better, Joe. I know it will. David will come home soon and we'll build the house up again. And we'll find a nice skin lotion for you. Everything's going to be all right, Joe. I know it will. We love you, Joe.
And I love you.
Oh, Joe! this poor man in his suffering. Help this poor man through his pain.
Amen.
Help this poor man in his anguish. Everybody pray. Everybody down on your knees to God. Okay. Not you, Mr. Benjamin. We'll do it, Joe. We'll pray for you.
Okay.
If you hear us, Lord, give us a sign. Make it known in our hearts, Lord, that you hear us.
Make it known.
Make it known in our souls, Lord, that you hear us.
Make it known.
Make it known in our ears, Lord, that you hear us.
May it know.
Everybody.
Amen, Lord.
Amen, Lord. Oh, I bit my tongue.
Oh, God. Look, his tongue is swelling up. Look at it. He doesn't have enough room in his mouth. Oh, Daddy. Poor Daddy.
Poor Mr. Benjamin. Poor Mr. Benjamin.
Porcupine needles. Have a good time, Joe. Come, children.
Okay, we'll go. But as soon as I know the others are all right, I'm coming back. I'm not David. Goodbye, Dad. Good luck. Son, it hurts, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm.
I'm sorry.
Sarah. One kiss. One goodbye kiss.
What if I touch your ears?
A kiss from you could never hurt. That's the first time I felt good in 3 days.
Some young couple with a small apartment. I love you, Joe. I forgive you.
What are you waiting for? Go.
We want to stay with you, Mr. Benjamin.
What does a suffering man living all alone in ashes need to and help for? Go with Mrs. Benjamin Morris. She needs you.
I have a sister who can come in 2 times a week.
Thank you. God bless you both.
Just thank you will be plenty, Mr. Benjamin.
May the Lord have mercy on his painful soul.
Hallelujah. Let's get the hell out of here.
What's next, God? What's next?
Joe.
What? Who said that?
Joseph Melvin Benjamin. This is your God.
Oh, God? God? Is it really you?
Didn't I just say it was? Of all the creatures on this earth, you are my favorite, Joe. I love you more than the birds and the butterflies and the crocodiles and the cockroaches. Especially the cockroaches.
Oh, thank you, Lord.
Your test is over. You have met the challenge of faith and have emerged triumphant. I love thee as thou lovest thine, and thee will be rewarded as thou would wish thine to reward thee.
Thank ye thy Lord?
Raise thyself to be blessed, Joseph. Knowing now that thy test is over, say the words, just for me, as a final tribute of thy love for me. Say it, Joseph. Say what thou couldst not say before. Say, I renounce God.
What?
It's all right! The test is over. It couldn't hurt, Joe.
What is this? It's a trick. That's what this is. It's a trick, isn't it?
It's not a trick! God does not trick. God is a busy man. Say it, Joe. Say it before I get upset.
A trick. That voice. I know that voice. It's not God. It's you, isn't it?
It's not me. Why would I lie? I'm God, I'm telling you. I'm God, I'm God, I'm God! April Fool.
I knew it. I knew that voice.
Tell the truth. Did I fool you? Huh? Joseph Melvin Benjamin, this is your God. I was hired once to do that in a temple on 88th and Park. I raised over $100,000 in donations.
Leave me alone today. Besides suffering, I'm not feeling well.
I don't blame you. Look at this place. If you don't get the screens up, you're going to have one buggy summer.
If I've lost everything else, why can't I lose you?
Can I make a suggestion about the furniture? Try Lemon Pledge. Rub it in for about 6 years and let it dry.
You're gloating, aren't you? You think you've beaten me. You think you've won. Well, you're wrong, Sydney. All I wait for now is my death.
Death? You got a long wait. You got 50, 60 years of healthy suffering in front of you yet. What are you talking about? You're in the prime of pain. Oh, by the way, I brought the list with me.
What list?
The previews, the coming attractions. Let me read you what's playing July 10th. August 14th. Hernia, gastritis, a double impacted wisdom tooth, a root canal job, the heartbreak of psoriasis, constipation, diarrhea, piles, dysentery, chills, fever, athlete's foot, lumbago, a touch of gonorrhea, and a general feeling of logginess. Nausea, heartburn, indigestion, upset stomach, diarrhea! Sorry, I couldn't help myself. All this, mind you, is on the left side of your body.
If I'm alive, I'll endure.
I'll endure. I've heard that one before. Would you like to know who renounced God today, Joe? If I told you who renounced God, you would be shocked. I couldn't believe it when I heard it.
I don't care.
Detroit. The entire city of Detroit renounced. Including 300 tourists just passing through.
I am what God made me.
And stop talking like you're Moses. You are not Moses. Moses was a big star. You're lucky God even pays attention to you.
I am an infinitesimal speck on the eyelash of the universe. But God sees me.
With binoculars? Maybe. Vain. That's what you are. Vain. Self-centered, and a swellhead. Who do you think you are to take up God's time like this? Do you know something? This will be the first time in 19 years that he misses the Christmas show at Radio City Music Hall. And for what? Look at you. A mess. Walking around in a loincloth and that
the cap dusted.
You look like a shepherd for the Salvation Army. I wasn't going to mention it before, but lately, you don't smell too good either.
It won't work, Sydney. No matter what you say, it won't work.
I hate this job. I can't take it anymore. I'm having a nervous breakdown. Why doesn't God help me? Why should you be the favorite?
I'm sorry, Sydney. How can I help you?
Well, if you won't renounce God, then will you?
Well, I what, Sydney? Ask me.
Will you give me a letter of recommendation? I've been fired.
No. Oh, Sydney, don't tell me.
God laid off 1,400 people today. Everybody went. Messengers, angels, bishops, Hebrew school teachers. I saw two cardinals trying to get jobs a chock full of nuts. It's because of inflation. Do you know what red velvet slippers cost today? I haven't even told Sylvester yet.
He sounds like a good man. He'll understand.
There goes our dream of Florida. You know how far south Sylvester has been in his life? Canal Street!
outside.
Then why did you come here today?
I was hoping I could change your mind. If I could get this account, they might reconsider.
God understands. He'll provide.
He wouldn't even say hello to me in the hallway. I'm 44 years old. What am I going to do now? It's a little late in life to take up pro football.
Sydney, we all have our own burdens to take on.
Sure. The poor carry their burdens, and the rich have them delivered. Where's the justice? Well, I don't care anymore. What can he do to me now? Hey, God, do you hear me? I renounce you, God.
No, no, don't do that.
I give you up, God. Thanks for nothing. The devil cares more about people. At least he entertains them. The Exorcist grossed over $130 million. Domestic.
Take it back, Sydney.
Hey, God, you hear me? May you have the same lousy weather you give us every year, especially Labor Day weekend.
Sydney, we all have our own tests to go through.
Why did you have to be mine? Even you couldn't take you, believe me. What have I done?
Shh, Sydney, it's okay, it's okay.
Tell him I'm sorry, Joe. You, he knows you, he likes you. Mm-hmm. He'll listen to you. Tell him not to forsake me.
Yes, yes, okay. I'll tell him.
You will? Thank you, Joseph. I have to go now. I have an interview at 2:00 with United Parcel.
Good luck, Sydney.
Shh, listen.
What?
I hear something. Someone's out there.
Where?
There. Did you see it move?
Where should I look? There's nothing out there but smoke and ash.
And a bush. See that one bush over there? It's still burning a little on the bottom. There's someone behind there.
Behind the burning bush?
Did you hear what you said?
What did I say?
Behind the burning bush. Anything strike you familiar about that place?
What do you say?
Oh, nothing.
What are you implying?
Nothing, but don't ask me what I'm thinking.
Is it?
I doubt it. He never makes house calls, but with you, who knows?
Oh. Oh my God.
It's possible. Your test isn't over yet, Joe. Maybe he's going for a big finish. This is no place for me. Goodbye, Joe.
No, Sydney, stay. Help me.
Hold out. Whatever they do to you now, hold out another few minutes. Just keep saying, you love God, and Monday morning you'll be back in the box business, Joe.
I'm not interested in the box business anymore.
Don't turn it down. I can run it for you. I'm available.
Sydney, don't go. I need you.
Good luck, Joe. If you think of it, give me an autograph.
Hello? Who's out there? What do you want? What more do you want from me? Will you at least say something? Say something, please!
Thanks for the lamp. What's for dinner?
Oh, I smell charcoal.